Chris, BBTV, we're at Peter Fiore's gym out here in Cheshire, and Will Howe, heavyweight prospects, is here. It's good to see you, Will. You know, I was just saying it was probably about a year ago or so, maybe a bit over last...
Yeah. No, I think probably a bit less, actually, about 8 months.
Was it? Eight months. But you've been here a while, though. It's good to see you still here and still grafting. And
still grafting away, living in my bedroom, so living in the gym. Still loving it.
Yeah. Well, yeah, heavyweight amateur prospects. You can tell us, you know, what you've done in the amateurs as well, and, you know, inform us on all that. But you've got the ABAs coming up as well, and then after that, you're going to go pro.
I'm already 7-time national champion, two-time European medalist. Obviously, I've got now coming up the ABAs. I've just got my pro license through. And now I've got the ABAs coming up. Obviously, before time I get my pro fight, so it was just nice timing just to keep fighting, keep training, keep taking over, really. But they start this Saturday, but I've got a bye, so I probably won't fight the 2nd of April, pre-quarters.
Have you done the ABAs before? Have you already run the ABAs?
Yeah, being a 7-time ABA champion through my years. Obviously, through my age group and that, and then being away multiple international bouts and that, so I've done my time really as an amateur. I've done a lot in the amateurs.
You certainly have, yeah. So it feels the right time to turn pro.
Yeah, it does.
You're biting at the bit now, so it's just the ABAs is something you want to sort of sign off with.
It would be lovely to sign off with an ABA belt. Obviously, down here with Peter and that, training with Peter, it'd be a nice way to finish your amateur career. I boxed last time I seen you for about another 7 or 8 amateurs. I've won the Northern Area belt. I was meant to fight last Saturday for an English belt, what ranks you one for the ABA sort of thing. But that didn't come off. The lad pulled out injured after illness, one of them. I'm just looking forward to it now. I'm training, so I'm just looking forward to the ABAs. So I'm ready, really.
And you're training all right. You're here. You're living in the gym.
Yeah,
there's not many boxers live in the gym, so you can open your bedroom door and you're in the gym.
Train all the time.
You know what? Let me just spin round and show them your door there, so we get a little idea. And everyone's sort of eating there. So there's your bedroom door, and you walk out of there. Yeah. Into there.
Yeah. Every morning, half 8, we start training. Half 8. I'd probably an hour and a half I'd push. This morning we've done a weighted endurance training with the barbell. It was reps of 1, 3, 5, 9, 9, 7, 5, 3, 1 of 7 exercises with 10 kilo plates on either side all the way through the trip with me, Yui and Peter Clark. Yeah.
Great training. Yeah.
And then just there, 7 rounds body spam with everyone in the gym. So I've got brilliant prep, and then just finished off with 4 rounds on the bags. So I've got brilliant prep for these ABAs. I'm looking forward to getting in.
You know what, Will, there's probably a lot of fighters out there who would love to be in here with Peter, living in Peter's gym and having Yui to train alongside and having a knowledge of Peter.
It's a knowledge of both of them.
You think of what you've got here, I mean.
I'm very lucky, very lucky. Obviously, the knowledge of Yui's been in my situation now, coming through and learning. So, learning off Yui and taking in Peter's knowledge is, I think, some brilliant thing, asset to my boxing. And obviously, I've just got to listen now, and I've just got to do it. Do you know what I mean? I've got to do and pick up and practice every time. It's a lot of practice. I'm just on the first step, really, with this new side of my trainer. I probably haven't even got my foot on it yet, so so it's just about that learning bit now.
How did it come about? Like, you came up here to Cheshire, you know, north east to the north west.
I was in France for about 6-7 weeks, sparring with Yui for the Hunter fight. That was obviously back in early June. So we'd done that, and then we'd come back, we'd had a bit of time off, and then I'd end up coming back down here, retrain, be part of the sparring camp again, obviously talking to Peter and that, saying about turning over. Really, I'd have probably stayed amateur, but Peter was the only person that I would have turned over with, really. I think, obviously, his sort of teaching and my style, I think, would benefit me, do you know what I mean? So obviously it was the only person that I would have turned over with. So I'm just obviously, so from there we've just built the relationship and we've just I've ended up here now. So living in the gym, enjoying every moment of it. As you know, all goes by dead fast, so I just take everyone's word for it and just enjoy every moment.
You're taking it all in.
Yeah, take it all in.
What's it like if you could explain, you know, being with Peter and being around him as a trainer and being around the family, if you like? I mean, you're like one of the family, aren't you, at the moment?
You're living here, obviously, as one of them, with them all. It's brilliant. We just take in, obviously. We just do our own thing. Go to bed, go to sleep, go over sometimes and go and sit with young Peter. You just chill out, everyone just talks, just natural, do you know what I mean? It's just like, fitting, really. Do you know what I mean?
Brilliant. And you get a lot of good sparring as well. You get a lot of people coming down here to spar, yeah. So you get your share of that as well. And you've been doing a lot of sparring off by yourself as well. I know Dave Allen, we were talking, you've been sparring with him recently. Yeah, who else as well? You've got quite a lot of well-known fighters.
I've been doing a lot of sparring. I sparred with Nathan Gorman for the before the Wardley fight. I was down there multiple rounds. And then I was sparring him, when was that? Was that November?
Yeah,
I was part of that camp, and then obviously I was fighting myself early December, so time I'd come off them camps, I'd had about seven fights, just come off them, being Christmas and that, and then come back into camp with the amateurs with Billing Boxing Club, being down there, they sorted some sparring out with Dave Allen, going down there, went down to Barnsley and then he come up with us, but good rounds with Dave, he's experienced, isn't he? He's been around, knows what he's doing, knows if how to wind you up or pull back or make you throw or make you miss and that. He's a good boxer, do you know what I mean? So obviously he's experienced, and these are the people that I'm learning off now. These are the sort of person like Yui, brilliant one to learn off. Nathan, obviously been around, and Dave Allen, brilliant person to be in the ring with, all experienced, all know what they're doing. They don't miss a shot, if you get what I mean. They don't miss a shot.
Yeah, great experience for you, lad. Yeah. So you've got big dreams, obviously, going forward in the heavyweight division. It's a great time to join it as well.
I feel like.
So do you feel
obviously
that?
There's the top end of it now. Obviously, with all the people out there, and then there's all the prospects pushing through now, pushing through with it all, with Johnny Fisher. Enrico Tuma and Matty Harris, all these. There's loads of people pushing through the rails now to get there. So it's a brilliant time to join. I feel like I'm ready. I feel like I'm complete. Bring something different to what everyone else brings. So I'm gonna go in and do the business.
Forward to see. What do you feel like you'll bring different?
I'm ready to fight. Ready to fight. I'm go in there. I'll give everyone a show, give everyone entertainment. I'll go in there, put it all on the line, put my heart on the line. I'm one of them. I won't miss a fight or turn someone away. If that's a fight, that's a fight, and that's a fight I'll go for. I'll never turn or ever think, oh, I don't really want to be in there with him or anything like that. So that's the sort of fighter I am. I'm an all out brawler.
Well, watch this space. Bye, Peter. Bye. It's good to see you.
See you in the morning.
Peter out of China.
Yeah.
Watch this space. Will Howe, heavyweight prospect. He's going to be turning pro soon, and he's definitely one to look out for.
Definitely.
We're going to follow the journey along the way, no doubt about it.
Thank you very much.
God bless, Will, and they'll catch up soon.